meters waiting for sharks.
How about?
I think that looks perfect.
Don't go too much further over, though, because we want them to come up the slope, and then we can deploy the tags from here. Right. The dorsal fin is likely to be where the starboard element right. is, and that is going to be a safer shot to not injure the animal.
All right. Lights out?
Yep. Here we go. Oh, here we go, sixgill. Oh, yeah, okay.
Whoa.
Okay.
You want some white light?
Yes. Okay. Hey.
Tell me about sharks.
What do you want to know about sharks?
Tell you about sharks. What do you want to know about sharks? I mean, I've been studying sharks for the last 25, 30 years or so.
How old am I?
Yeah, about 30 years. That's hard to believe. I got interested in sixgill sharks. Well, I've always been interested in sixgill sharks.
So incredibly awkward.
Sixgills are pretty cool. It's sort of like seeing a dinosaur because they swam around the same time the dinosaurs were walking around.
We have teeth that are clearly from sixgills that are in the fossil record about 180 million years ago.
They're also just enormous.
It's a big, robust shark with a huge, wide head.
Their jaws open really wide.
That weak jaw actually allows all those teeth to bend across the surface of a whale or whatever it may be and carve out chunks of flesh.
And people don't know a whole lot about them. They live in complete darkness, and you don't see them that much. Most people don't know they exist.
In order to be able to protect animals, to be able to understand them, to be able to manage resources, we have to know about them. We have to know what the daily life of these animals are. Do they move a long way? Do they move up in the water column? Do they have a lot of babies? Do the babies go other places? What do they eat? Are the babies eaten by other things?
We can get a huge amount of information from tagging sharks. And the beautiful thing about satellite tags is that they only require us to see that animal one time.
But in the past, to get our hands on them, to actually figure out what their normal behavior looks like, we have to capture them in the same way a commercial fishery would. We have to set a long line on the bottom, haul them up hundreds of meters, and cause that stressful event.
Tag it, measure it, release it. And if you think about that, for a deep sea shark like a sixgill, there's light trauma potentially, because they don't ever experience light that bright. Thermal trauma, because it's way hotter than they're used to experiencing. Pressure differences. And then if you bring them on board the boat, just the physical strain of putting the animal's weight on its organs and everything. And so in some ways, it's amazing they survive all that, but they do survive it.
They swim back down, and it takes them a while, like 24 to 48 hours to resume normal behavior, we think. The only way to actually validate that, to see if that's strange behavior due to the capture event and figure out how long that stress actually causes a change in behavior, is to tag them at depth without actually pulling them up.
For 10 years now, I've been wanting to tag sharks from the submarine, you know, tag them where they live, tag them in their own habitat. And so to be able to go down in a submarine, tag the animal in its natural environment.
You're presented with a whole bunch of new things that they do that you didn't even realize were questions that were interesting, right?
These spears aren't gonna go in very deep. They're gonna implant a tag exactly as we would do at the surface. This tagging process is far less invasive, and it gives us insights into what they're doing without us affecting that behavior.
So this is the third trip that we tried to tag sixgill sharks from the sub. So we feel like we're getting closer each time.
We get closer and closer every time, but yeah, I feel the pressure at this point. We really need to get it done.
I'm nervous about it, very nervous, because this very well could be our last chance. So hopefully this is tonight, the last night. Hopefully this is the one.
But actually, just being in the sub at depth is really very exciting. But I know that that a lot is resting on this, so as soon as I get a shot, I'm going to take it. So.
All right.
Here we go. Oh, here we go. Sixgill. Oh yeah. Okay. Okay.
Whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. He's a sixgill.
Hey, control, Nadir, we have our first blunt nose. First blunt nose.
Let me turn on the light.
Yep. Okay.
Wow.
That's enormous. Look at the length of that thing. Okay, let's just measure it. He is wider than the sub.
The sub is long.
Look, I hope you're getting footage because this is ridiculously cool. My God, this is great.
Is that a male or a female?
It's a female.
Control Nadir, we have a very large female. Over.
Roger, Nadir, you have a sixgill. Roger.
What?
So fucking excited.
My goodness.
Where's my phone?
That's bigger than most white sharks. Whoa. Look at the width of that thing. My goodness.
The head is as big as the tray.
The head is 3 feet wide. That is an enormous animal. She's pushing
the whole sub.
She's bumping the sub.
Oh,
she's going to scratch it. Look at the eye.
She's moving the sub.
Yeah, it's definitely a female. Look at that. It's huge. I'm not going to take a shot until I'm absolutely sure, because we're getting some good footage, and as soon as I shoot her, she's going to get spooked. That's a lot more than 4 meters. Because the width of it was right here.
Should I disarm just in case?
Oh, here she is.
Whoa.
Yeah, see, definitely female, you can tell. That tail. It was like right here.
They need to give us a little more oxygen.
Oh, really?
I'm breathing pretty heavy.
Damn. That was big. My goodness.
I think that light might be scaring her away.
Okay.
You want me to turn it off?
Yeah, switch it off.
Oh, look.
Oh, my goodness. What a visitor. This is the same one, right?
I don't know.
That's a different one.
Is it?
Different one. Okay, arm.
Arm?
Yeah. He's underneath it. He's right here.
Arm. You want some white light?
No, yes. White light now.
White light now?
Yep. Okay.
Oh. You fired one.
Yeah, I did.
It's in him.
Is it?
I can't see. Yeah, it's in him.
Okay. Whoa!
He's rolling. Oh my God! I don't know what you did, Gavin, but you got him.
Yeah. I just saw his fin. I knew it was in approximately the right place.
Okay, close your switch, please.
Okay.
Everybody take a breath.
See what we can see.
Oh.
Control the deer, shot fired. We think it went in. There is too much silt to tell. Over.
Roger the deer, tag went into a large male.
Wait, I think I see the spear laying there. Do you see like a line?
Oh, I can see the lanyard. Look, there's a lanyard going up there.
Where?
Right here.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I see it.
Got it.
That means that the animal was speared, and we have not found the tag,
And so
the... And the spear came out of it.
And the spear came out of it, which means that the tag is elsewhere, hopefully on the animal.
Dang, is it right? Wow.
That's the most fucking incredible thing I've ever done in my life.
Awesome.
Ever. And I'm old.
All science at some level is you're trying to figure something out that no one's figured out before. Even if it's a small piece and it all builds. My real passion is doing the science that contributes to problem solving.
It's really nice to work with people that like doing things as well as they can be done.
This is game-changing for us and for marine scientists more broadly. Tagging a sixgill shark to depth for the first time will not only provide new data for our specific research, but it also opens up a new frontier on how scientists can study deep-sea animals in a less invasive way.